Me cuesta mucho trabajo todo esto.
No saben cuánto.
Bueno, sí saben, porque se pueden dar cuenta. I'm so sorry. Oh my gosh, I thought I had this figured out. Ay, my sweet Olivia. Okay, so what is wrong with this? Why is it not pointed? Okay, there we go. Does this make sense? Can you see it okay? My gosh. Okay, half an hour just to get this started. There we go. Okay, let's try it like this. He's telling me to rotate my phone, but can you see it okay, Olivia? I know that you're connected, so I need to ask you. Let's see, like that, maybe? He's not telling me to rotate my phone anymore, so I'm assuming yes. Good. Okay. Yay. So, oh, okay. So here are the samples, okay? We can make something crazy and colorful like this, and you can make it as big as you want, okay? So just remember that the bigger you do it, it's just gonna take a little bit more time to color, okay? And so you can make it in any way you want. Lo pueden hacer de la manera que ustedes quieran, okay? And so just decide if you want two eyes open, if you want an eye open and an eye closed, if you want a hat. If you're a boy, I don't mean to leave you out. You can make curly hair. You can make, and I'll show you, we can make curls like this. Si tienes el pelo chino y eres un niño, no quiero que te sientas solito. Podemos hacer chinitos así, o podemos hacer piquitos, así como spiky hair, como, you can make spiky hair if you're a boy, short hair. Hey, I was a girl with short hair, so, and I had a spiky, so I may try that. So what I did was I cut a sheet in two, okay, because maybe later we can try to do a puppy too. Hopefully we'll have enough time. And we can do a puppy, you can turn out like this, and or even crazier. I'll show you how. Okay, so you're gonna need, vamos a necesitar tus pinceles, your brushes, your pencil, maybe a brush like this. I'm gonna use a marker so you can see what I'm doing. Well, I don't know, sometimes I still make mistakes. Like I said, I'm learning with you. So, do I even have a pencil with me? How about using it to practice? And I don't think I put it back. I have my eraser here. And I don't know where I left my pencil. Oh, here it is. It is here. Aquí está mi lápiz también. Okay. Porque todavía me equivoco de repente. Así que todavía estamos aprendiendo juntos. We're learning together. So, and I still brought these watercolor pencils because I want to show you how to do them, how to use them, in case you don't know how. Traje mis colores de acuarela para enseñarte cómo se hacen. He estado practicando con ellos para enseñarte también a ti. Así que podemos tratar. So we can try. And I also brought my Artesa markers to show you too. Excuse me, I have a little frog in my throat. But again, you use whatever you have, okay? Utiliza lo que tú tengas. No hay problema. Si tienes colores normales, no hay problema. Si tienes plumones, si tienes, if you have Sharpies, whatever you have is fine, okay? And I know that we usually use markers. We usually use markers like this or the Crayola. And we mix it up in our little palette. So we can do it like that too. I just wanted to show you, to have more vibrant colors, we need to use the markers on our paper. Para tener colores más vivos, como pueden ver, y que no sean tan suaves, tenemos que utilizar el color aquí mismo, okay? Okay, so life is crazy. Sometimes some things are, problems are bigger, some problems are a little smaller. So we're gonna start with the eyes like that, okay? And sometimes they can be twisted and we're gonna just be crazy. vamos a hacer las cosas un poquito loquitas, ¿ok? Así que, manos a la obra. Empecemos para poder acabar pronto. Podemos hacerlo de esta manera. Use your paper long ways, ¿ok? ¡Hola! ¡Hola, Taide! Taide 1. Madre mía, qué gusto verte por aquí. ¿Cómo me encanta que vengan? ¿Cómo me encanta que vengan a verme? Agarren su papel vertical. Use your paper vertically, ¿ok? And we're going to start by doing... I'm going to chance it just because I want you to see it nice and big. Otherwise, I'll use the other side if I make a mistake. But I want you to be able to see what I do, okay? Let's start with... You go at around, I would say, you know, cut your paper in four parts. Go to the third part right here, okay? And... Corten su papel, si lo dividen en cuatro partes, vayan a la tercera parte, aquí, arribita de la mitad. Right above the half, in the center, and make a big eye. Okay? An almond shape, una forma de almendra. Así, okay? And then you're gonna cut it in half, like that. Okay? And then, you're going to make your other eye. Van a hacer el otro ojo. Esto va a ser un ojo, okay? The other eye, where do you want it? Maybe we're going to go crazy and make it here. A little bit smaller, a little bit bigger. I want to make it smaller. Just like that. I'm going to close it. Like that. Okay? And then, because Picasso, he wanted... His idea was to see the face of a person in every angle. I don't know if you've learned about Picasso, but that's what he wanted to do. He wanted to see a face from every angle. A Picasso le gustaba ver a una persona en diferentes ángulos en una pintura, en dos dimensiones, y es difícil. Por lo tanto, él dibujaba la nariz y los ojos y las manos y todo en una sola parte. So he would do the nose and the eyes and the profile and the face, I mean the ears, in one page. So that's why we need, this gonna look a little bit crazy, okay? So we're gonna do our nose and we can go, is the forehead and then the nose and then we can go like this and then the nose, okay? And then the lips. I'm gonna go like this. And then like that. Now this marker I think is dying. Este plumón negro parece que se me está muriendo. Le falta más tinta. Okay? Okay. So here is our lips. And then to make it even crazier, we are gonna make the chin here a little square like that, okay? And then the eyelashes. Now if you're a boy, you can just make a line like this. Oh wait, let's close this area first. Vamos a cerrar la cara. Esta parte de aquí va a ser un círculo. We're gonna make a circle here. Like that. And then we're gonna close it like this. It looks a little crazy, right? And then our eyelashes. If you're a boy, you don't have to do this. If you don't want eyelashes, that's fine. If you want them, hey, you're more than welcome to use them or to paint them. Oh my gosh, this marker is just not... That'd be good. Let me see if I have another. I'm gonna switch to my Crayola. Okay. And then, okay. So here is our eye with our eyelashes. And then we're gonna do a little bit of bangs. And you can do a hat too. If you're a boy, hey, more than welcome to do a hat. A hat, you can make it, well, this is a girl hat maybe, but you can make like a square hat, a round hat, or something like that, okay? If you want to do a hat, you're more than welcome to. I'll leave this over here so you can see it, maybe. Let me see the profile. There you go, like that. Okay? Now this looks, it's gonna look different than this one, okay? Because I like to experiment myself. And so you can do a hat or you can do bangs. I like to do bangs. I'm gonna do some bangs here, like that. I use Picasso like geometrical shapes. A Van Gogh le gustaba utilizar las figuras geométricas. Así que estos van a ser como triangulitos, como zigzags, like zigzags. And then you can make some and then quit. And then if you want to make a hat, this would be where you would make like a little something. I would make like a long rectangle, and then maybe you can make a little hat like that. I mean, it's really crazy, so you don't have to be relative to the face, okay? And then, oh my gosh, these shades are not, okay, I'm gonna try this. Hold on 1 second, let me see if I have another marker here, another black marker, because of course it's not working. Well, I'll try this one, but I don't know if I'm gonna like this one. Okay, and so over here we finished this hair right there. Vamos a terminar el pelo por aquí. Y esta cabeza, this head, we're gonna finish it up like a square, like that. Crazy, right? La cabeza la terminamos un poco cuadrada. Aquí va a estar el ojo. This is the eye. So we're gonna do a little circle like that. And then another circle inside, like that. And then I'm gonna do my eyelashes. Close it from here to here. Cerremos, porque esto nos va a dar la oportunidad de hacer diferentes colores. That will give us the opportunity to have different colors on the top part or the lower part. So close these areas right here and just do the eyelashes, okay? Like that, crazy. Just straight, don't even make a curve, just straight down. You can even make some down here if you want to, okay? And then we can even make a mouth over here. Even a little cricket, like that. And then you can make smaller part over here. Hagamos la boca y luego un corazón aquí y luego una chapita por aquí. And then your little cheeks, your little blush, just to make them crazy. And then your neck is gonna go right here. And then I'm gonna make a necklace. And it's gonna be all full of. It's gonna be crazy, okay? It's not gonna be a regular old fashioned necklace. I wanna do it like, it's gonna look like grapes. And you can do, hey, this is where your imagination starts, okay? Do it any way you want. And then it's gonna be like this, and then maybe a heart here, and then maybe like this, and then maybe even a star right there. Okay. Después, este va a ser el collar, ¿ok? Este es un collar medio loquito, que parecen uvas. Aquí me gusta esta mano porque yo pinto, me gusta pintar. Así que hice una mano chueca con picos con un pincel. I like to paint, so my hand is a little bit crazy and short. See, it's like that. Oh, what was that? Short like that, and then my finger starts here, and then here. It doesn't even make sense, right? Hands don't look like that. But, hey, it's Van Gogh, so yes. I mean, not Van Gogh, Picasso. I keep saying Van Gogh. He's channeling me, like that. And then I'm gonna do a little brush. Un pincel por aquí, así.
más o menos, aquí las gotitas de pintura, the drops of paint. And then you can even make, you know what, I'm gonna make a shoe right here. Let's make a shoe. Why don't we make a weird looking, maybe like a witch looking shoe.
Why not?
And then like that, connecting to the body, because it never made sense in Van Gogh's eyes. And Van Gogh, see, again, he's challenging me, Picasso. And then the arm comes here, and then it's gonna be connected to the foot. I don't know, just crazy. Over here, the ear is gonna be behind, the drops here, and then the other ear, la otra oreja, por aquí.
Hola, hola, Katie. Oh, good, Zoe's here, good, Zoe, hi. Hola, hola, mi Sophie, qué bueno que estás aquí, Damare, Damari, qué bueno que también estás aquí, yay.
Let's have fun. Okay, and then we are going to paint this part. Let's paint this side of the head with curls, okay? So if you have curly hair, si tienes rulitos o chinitos, como decimos en México, aquí va como, swirl, swirl away, swirl away. And the lines combine because that's how we paint. We swirl and swirl and swirl, like that. And then, sometimes what you can do is take the very end, agarra el final del caracol, y lo agarras y lo traes de vuelta para dibujar el final del chino. ¿Mm? Y también pueden hacer el pelo. You can also make the hair like this. It just flows away, just like that. See? Flows away is the hair, okay? This is the ear, okay? So it's, it's supposed to be the ear. And then the earring, do an earring, whatever. If you want an earring, if not, if you're a boy, you're joining us, that's fine too. You don't have to do any earring. You can make another curl over here if you want. We have curly hair this day. I can never have curls myself, but hey. My hair never curls. Mi pelo nunca se enchina. Por más que trato, nunca se enchina. And then we have more hair flowing this way, okay? And it's just crazy like that. Our hair was just going everywhere. And we just make fun shapes like that. Okay? We're doing okay? We forgot our eyebrows. Well, we didn't forget. We're just gonna make them now. So we're gonna make the eyebrow like that. And then the other eyebrow like that. And in fact, if you wanna connect to the face, that will give you an opportunity to do more color. Si la quieren conectar hasta la cara, también está bien porque pueden así dar otra sección para más color. Así como si quieren conectarla así, por ejemplo, la pueden conectar a una pestaña y da una sección para otro color. Porque cada sección son diferentes colores. We can use the sections for different colors. Okay? All right, so we have our sketch, more or less. And so let's color away. It's fun time. Okay, so you have your sketch. Tienen su sketch más o menos. Ahora, what I like to show you is, if you're doing it with markers, I'm gonna do a section with markers and I'm gonna try these colors like I mentioned before. I wanna show you how these colors work, these watercolor water pencils work. But I'm gonna try the markers first so you know how I combine colors to make these shades like this. Okay, so let me use the orange. I'm gonna use these Artesa colors, but again, you use whatever you want to use. Where's the orange? Here it is. To give this shadow, para darle este sombrero de más oscuro, me voy a ir de naranja a amarillo. Estoy utilizando colores del mismo que están, o sea, uno al lado del otro. I don't know my art terms. And it starts with an A. But obviously, I don't know my technical terms. I'm a self-taught artist, so I don't know sometimes the terms, but I just know that when you choose colors that in the color wheel, oh, I meant to have the color wheel with me, so to show you, I don't have it. It just they look so pretty. So, okay, so we have like this. Vamos a hacerlo así. Van a hacer un sombreado de esta manera. También con sus colores, si quieren. You can also do it with your colors. I have to be careful with this marker because it bleeds. Okay. And then I leave it like that. See, I just do the corners or the edges. Okay. And then, so I'm going to put them here because I use them. On this side of the face, I'm going to do, what about green and blue? I'm going to do probably blue on this side. Green, but another type of green. Maybe this green. Yeah. Okay, voy a utilizar de este lado el azul. El azul. También voy a meterme por aquí, aunque sea pelo. Y a lo mejor hago otro sombrero de azul acá abajo. You can play with your colors. Even if you're using the same color, aunque estén usando los mismos colores, pueden jugar con el tipo de color que están utilizando. A lo mejor es otro, ese mismo color, pero en otro shade, en otro, ay caray, se me van los nombres. Un poco más claro, un poco más oscuro. ¿Saben a lo que me refiero? Sí, más o menos. Lo utilizo de este lado, ahorita van a ver lo que vamos a hacer. And then, on this side of this blue, I'm going to use this green that I have ready. I'm gonna use it here, like that. And then I'm going to use green here anyway. Use it the same green. I'm just gonna change the colors up here. Estoy haciendo, vamos a utilizar un tipo, vamos a cambiar este color a este color para que se haga este tipo de sombreado. Queda muy padre. Entonces, por eso nada más estoy haciendo las orillas y no los estoy uniendo. I'm not joining them just yet. I'm going to show you how to do it. Okay, so let's start with the face like that so I can show you how to do it. Vamos a empezar con juntando estos dos colores. Hasta dónde vamos para que sepan más o menos a lo que me refiero. Si empezamos con este color, con el amarillo, if we start with the yellow, I'm going to start with a lighter color. Empiezo con el color más claro y lo voy a jalar con mi pincel para lo blanco, ¿sí? Con el agua, con muy poca agua, no utilicen demasiada agua, ¿ok? Para que se quede el más color posible en el papel. No utilicen demasiada agua, muy poquita, muy poquita. ¿Se fijan cómo el negro este que utilicé, como es el de Crayola, se hace, crea un bleed, como quien dice? Pero pues bueno, luego lo corrijo más tarde. Es bueno utilizar algo que no sé, que no haga ese estilo. Es como un, si utilizamos un color permanente, un negro permanente, un plumón permanente, no haría eso. Pero como es de agua, crea ese, con el agua empieza a reaccionar. But it's okay. See, now I'm doing it with the orange. I didn't even use any more water. I'm using the same water. Estoy utilizando la misma agua que utilicé para este lado, trayendo el amarillo para acá. Pero así se unen los dos colores y da el sombreado, aquí más fuerte el naranja y aquí más claro el amarillo. So you see the shadow of combining the two colors together, you see? And it's really pretty. So I'm gonna take the color away. I'm gonna take it away with the water. Take it away with with your napkin. Wash it again. Use a little bit of water. What I'm doing is when I do this with my water, I go like this to make sure the color is gone. I make sure there is barely any water in here. You can always get more water, but you cannot take the water away once you have it on your paper, okay? So it's best to start with as little water as possible and then get more if you need it than to have too much water. Es mejor empezar con poquita agua y traer más que al revés. Porque una vez que tienes demasiada agua en tu papel, es difícil darle el look que necesitas después. Así que empieza con poquita agua y trae más si la necesitas. Entonces empiezo así y luego la combino con el color más oscuro, que sería el azul. ¿Sí están viendo? En este caso, de este lado. Y se combina de esta manera. Okay? So these are the markers, the Artisa markers that I was talking about. These are very water-based, so a little bit goes a long way. And I like the intensity of the colors. Me encanta la intensidad de los colores. Entonces, I'm using more of this green over here. And then I'm going to, I'm not even taking away the color because I like to combine them a little bit. And this color is not that light. If it were lighter, I wouldn't have combined them, but it's, they mix very well together. So I'm using the intensity of this green to play with this color. Estoy utilizando la intensidad de este verde para que se combine muy bonito con este otro, que es como un azul verde, pero como son más, tienen más o menos el mismo tinte, se ven muy bonitos. Voy a agarrar un poquitito más de agua. And I try to make the water last as much as possible. Trato de utilizar la poquita agua que tengo lo más que se pueda y no agarrar más, para que no tener tanta agua, porque es difícil dar el mismo look. It's really hard to give the same look if you have too much water. So use a little water to go a long way and combine both colors like that. See, my black is really bleeding. I'm gonna have to fix it later, but it's okay. I'll show you how. Okay? ¿Cómo van? ¿Bien? Espero que sí.
Nosotros igual. Ay, compañera. Ay, sí, señora María Clara. Qué bueno que están aquí otra vez. Señor Luis, qué bueno que están por aquí.
Qué gusto, de verdad. Y más porque no pintan. Están solamente por gusto y no saben qué emoción me da, de verdad. Espero que les guste, que estén disfrutándolo y que también aprendan a pintar. Es una terapia muy, muy bonita. Bueno, ok. Este color, aquí me gustaría a lo mejor, ¿qué les parece un morado con rosa? Let's put some purple and pink over here. Yeah? Let's do our purple on that side, maybe. No, maybe on this side, so we can have the lighter colors on this side. That's how you go more or less by the lighting of it, so it looks kind of consistent. At least that's what I think. Oh, not that Picasso was consistent. Decía que de este lado decidí poner el rosa para que se vea un poco más claro, para ser consistente acá arriba con mis colores, pero dije, bueno, no que Picasso fuera muy consistente, que digamos, con sus cosas, pero bueno, igual nos estamos divirtiendo, ¿verdad? Aquí está mi morado, my purple. I'm gonna use it. It's not a very dark purple. I thought it was gonna be purple. I mean, more dark. Creí que iba a ser un morado un poco más oscuro, pero no. No importa. Igual me gusta mucho. Purple is Taide Sofía's favorite color. She loves purple. A Taide Sofía le encanta el color morado. Le puede fascinar. A ver, tengo mucha agua, creo. Sí. Le quito bien el color. I make sure my brush is very colorless. Just a little bit of water. Because it's gonna go a long way. And you know what? I started the wrong way. Did anybody notice? I should have started on my lighter color. So it's no problem. What I do is I take out most of the color, just grab a little tiny bit of water, and then start pulling in this color. Yo empecé por el lado equivocado porque debía haber empezado de este lado que es más claro. Pero lo que hice fue quitarle el color, el morado, y simplemente agarré un poquito más de agua sin color y estoy ahora trabajando con el rosa, que es más claro. Y lo traemos hacia el morado. Si se fijan cómo hace demasiada, se junta demasiado. Este problema no se tiene si usas el color negro. Por eso quería cambiar de marcador. Ay, pero bueno. Ni hablar del peluquín, como decimos en México. No importa. Después, now let's do the eye. The way I did this eye, see? What I did here was I grabbed two shades of blue. And what I did here, however, is that I grabbed a shade of green in the middle and then blue in the outside. And I combined them together. See? You can see it better here. And you can leave that little dot of white if you want to make it a little bit of a shine. Lo que hice fue que puse el azul afuera y el verde adentro y los combiné. Ahora pueden hacerlo de otro color. It doesn't have to be the same. But that's what I did. What I did was another shade of blue. So let me share. I'm gonna grab, another blue, which, you know what? I'm gonna do like a little blue, like a blue purple. On the outside, like that. Oh, voy a hacer un poquito de azul morado y voy a poner un poco de verde adentro, un poco de verde, claro, un poco de verde adentro, para apenas se combinen. Ok, y con este que es más chico, with a smaller brush, I'm going to combine them. Esta vez empecé por afuera porque quiero utilizar solamente un poquito de color. I just I'm just using the very edge of the color to combine with the green, and that's why I started from the outside in. Empecé solamente por la esquinita del color para combinar, ¿ok? Más o menos así, y después le vamos a poner negro adentro, pero todavía no. Leave a little bit of white still, ¿ok? Or the whole entire inside eye in white, because we're gonna fill it in later. And I'm gonna do the eyelid in orange. Orange on this side, and then maybe yellow on this side. To bring in these colors over here. Para traer los colores del otro lado hacia adentro. I use my yellow first, and then I use my orange. Okay. All right. Then let's do. How about we do the hair or the hat? Crazy hat here. So I'm gonna do more detail on that hat. Voy a hacer un poco más de detalle en este gorrito para no pintarlo completamente. Como lo hice aquí, hice una florecita. Mira, una florecita en mi gorrito. Si quieren, that's if you want, okay? You can do that flower or not, or a heart, or you can do whatever you want. But for me, I'm gonna do it with a pencil because I don't know. The other marker is too, it's not working the way I want it. So I'm gonna do a little crazy flower here. It's not even, it's outside the hat even, you know? La flor está afuera del gorro. Y una hoja por aquí, otra hoja por acá. A little leaf here, a little leaf there. And then another one over here. Así más o menos. Okay. Okay. Y después, so let's do the hair. We're gonna come back to it later, so don't worry if it doesn't look good, okay? Don't worry about it. It's gonna be fine. Si no se ve perfecto o no les gusta todavía, recuerden que después lo delineamos un poquito mejor. Así que no se preocupen. Hagamos un poquito de... quería utilizar los colores. Les iba a enseñar cómo se utilizaban los colores. Aunque, bueno, pues aquí es muy... Es igual como se utilizan los plumones. Hago las orillas. Me salto una línea. I do the edges with the colors, just like I do with the markers. It's basically the same. I do the edges only. I just wanted to show you more or less how I use them. In case you were wanting to use them at some point, show you more or less how they work. Si quieren utilizarlos en algún momento, son muy padres. I like them. And then I go like this. And then I go like that. And then over here, I'm not sure what color I'm gonna use. This curl over here, este chinito por aquí. Vamos a hacerlo. Así. El vestido, no sé de qué color todavía, o la ropa. Y a lo mejor hago un poco más de detalle después. Ahora voy a moverme al otro color del pelo. I'm going to do it. Maybe like a light brown. going to use my brush. Maybe I will, no, yeah, I will use this one. I'm using this one, but you may want to use a smaller one, depending on how big your lines are. Voy a utilizar este tamaño, pero utilicen el tamaño que ustedes crean conveniente para, dependiendo del tamaño de sus líneas. Y se fijan cómo, ¡ay! ¡Ay, el negro! Se fijan cómo se trabaja súper fácil con los colores, pero aquí con el negro me está blideando demasiado. ¡Pocha, pocha, pocha! ¡Soy una pocha! A ver, pues ni modo, ¿qué le vamos a hacer? No tenía mi otro plumón negro para que no me pasen estas cosas. Don't use a water-based black marker so it won't bleed on you. No utilicen uno que sea base de agua para que no le sucedan estas cosas. Caramba, caramba. Pero sí se trabaja muy a gusto. If you want to use this next time, I highly recommend them. They are very, very easy to work with. I'll show you the brand. Si quieren utilizarlo, eso, los colores de acuarela la próxima vez son muy fáciles de utilizar. Y la verdad, sí me gustan bastante. Súper suavecitos. Ay, me choca que... Voy a poner un poquito más de color. Aquí a mí. A este pelito. Más de amarillo. ¿Alguna pregunta? Sí, aquí me preguntan, nada más que no estoy viendo mucho los mensajes. Dije, a lo mejor me han preguntado algo y yo ni en cuenta. Es difícil hacer las dos cosas, pero de veras que trato. Aquí hacemos así. Are you doing okay? Olivia, how are you doing, sweetie? Sofía, ¿cómo te está saliendo? ¿Bien? ¿Sí? ¡Yay! ¡Muy bien! I hope you're enjoying yourself. That's what is most important. Okay, so let's do the neck now. Let's let that dry. Let's do the... Oh, we have these curls over here. Oops. Oopsie doopsie. Let's do the curls over here. I didn't make them, did I? Okay. Like that, and like that. Okay. Well, a little gray there combined because of my black, but hey, you understand. Then the lips, let's do some red. Un rojito para los labios y con rosa. Voy a utilizar el rojo acá arriba. I'm going to do a red up here and pink down here, this lip, the lower lip. Because the lower lip is always lighter than the higher lip. Okay? So I'm going to do that. And then I'm going to do... barely any pink over here. Barely any. Just a little tiny bit. Okay. I'm gonna use a smaller brush, un poquito de agua. Recuerden que el labio de abajo es más claro que el labio de arriba, así que queremos más color aquí y un poquito de color aquí. Vamos a dejar un poquito de brillito ahí, así, ¿ok? Y yo puedo traer este color para acá porque pues combina, aunque no quiero que sea el mismo color del cachetito, pero ahorita le cambio. Podemos hacer este también de este lado. Vamos a hacerlo moradito. ¡Wow! ¡Ay! Se le cayó la punta. ¿Saben que cuando le saqué punta también se le cayó? Entonces utilizo... ¿Dónde está? Mi plumoncito morado. Bueno, eso este. Voy a pasar el color para acá. Okay. And what color do you want to do? I don't know if you did a brush like me, but I'm going to probably do it blue because we don't have a lot of blue on this side. Así que lo voy a hacer azul porque no tengo mucho azul de este lado. I'm going to do my hand, maybe I'm going to bring some green over here, I know, un poco loco, pero está bien, la vida es loquita de repente, así que por eso estamos celebrando el día de hoy con los colores vivos, ardientes, porque tenemos que disfrutar cada tono, cada sombra, cada brillo. We need to enjoy every single shade a color has to offer because life is crazy, just like this painting. And we need to enjoy it anyway. We need, it has a lot of color for us to see, to enjoy. So we need to just take it as it comes. And enjoy it the best way possible. Enjoy it very, very much. Because this life is too short. La vida es demasiado corta. Y a veces tengo que recordármelo yo misma. Porque yo soy muy preocupona. I worry a lot. So sometimes I need to remind myself. Hey, hey, take a chill pill. It's okay. It's going to be okay. I'm choosing random colors. Estoy escogiendo así colores super random. Porque... así como me vienen a la mente, los estoy escogiendo. You choose your own colors. You can follow my colors. You do whatever you feel you need to do. Okay, and then this one, I'm gonna do a lighter blue, maybe. Okay, more or less like that. Okay. And then... vamos a unir los colores, se fijan el tono,
Look at the difference. When I put water, look at how it turns. Like the color intensity is so, so, so beautiful.
See? And then, so I take my deep color, because it's the shadow of the neck, right? I want to leave it like that. Rinse my brush, and then I'm going to use this the lighter blue, and kind of, because it's a larger area than when I was working there. I'm going to do that, and then work myself up. Poco a poco me voy subiendo con mi color claro hasta que los colores tocan y se unen. Little by little, and then they join colors and they combine. And then it's just a beautiful merge of colors. Okay?
And that's when you get a color like that.
I'm gonna do the green now. What you can do too, I'm gonna show you, is when you have a large area like that, you can give the outline like that. Cuando tienen un área grande, y tienen, o sea, pueden, lo que también pueden hacer es, después de delinearlo de las orillas, le pueden poner otro color. En este caso lo voy a hacer con rosa.
With pink, for example.
And you can do it with your markers too. I'm gonna combine the colors here too. And it's going to also do a pretty cool thing. Not too much water, remember. Don't use too much water because you want the intensity of the color. No utilicen demasiada agua. Para que se pueda ver la intensidad del color.
A veces con... It depends also on your brush. If you have a very small brush like this one, it's harder to have more water on your brush. So you may need a little bit more water on this, in this case.
But with a bigger brush, it will hold more water. Tengan cuidado con el tamaño de su pincel, porque entre más grande, pues retiene más agua. Obviamente, entonces, dependiendo el tamaño de su pincel, van a retener más o menos agua. ¿Pueden ver más o menos? ¿Sí pueden ver bien? Lo estoy volteando para que puedan verlo mejor. I'm turning my paper if you, I don't know if you can see it well enough. So I want to make sure you can. Looks like a mermaid. Me salió como una sirena. La mano parece una colita de pescado, ¿a poco no? Hey, it's all about having fun. I still love it. That's what I love about these type of paintings. You never know what you're gonna come up with. And then be careful when you're painting and you have too much water. You don't want to put your hand on top of your water. and then I'm going to use this color for here. I What color? Oh, you know what? I'm gonna use this color too for the hat. Oh, I'm gonna turn it sideways to do the hat, this color. I'm gonna do it with my marker now, so you can see. I'm gonna do the outline. Hago solamente las orillitas con mi plumón marcador. Okay. Y traigo el agua hacia el centro. Primero hago las orillas. First I go around the edges to put water on the ink, and then I bring it down to the white. Sometimes I go back because it takes a couple of passes to be able to bring the ink into the white. You can kind of learn as you go. It's something that you learn as you paint more and more. And then the flower, la florecita, el centro es amarillo, y luego me di cuenta que me faltaron unos chinitos, unos rulitos, así que nomás se los voy a rellenar así. Esta es una oreja, no la cabe tampoco, le puedo poner un poquito de rosa. Más bien morada. I'm gonna do it purple because I feel like I don't have enough pink and purple. So I'm gonna do like a little pink purple color. And you know what? I'm gonna do the same over here. And you know what? I may do some of this color down here. Just like the edges, like that. Solo las orillas. Y con el pincel voy a trabajar todo lo que son los detallitos. Así. Y ahí está acá. Y con este pincel un poco más grandecito, I'm gonna use this one to kind of put a little bit of water here. A little bit of water here. Y tengo un poquito de este color, así que lo traigo para acá. Se fijan cómo llevo el color hacia arriba, donde está el blanco, y se va haciendo más claro, y más claro, y más claro. Pero se ve este parte de la pintura, sin ser demasiado. So you make like a swatch of the color by putting water in the, where there is the most color. And you kind of use your brush to bring it over to the white. You still use it even when you have a lot of marker. You feel like you don't even need to go in there, I still do it to still give it a watercolor look and use that color in my brush and the water I have to bring it over to the white like that. Use the very edge of my brush. Uso la mera puntita del pincel para las orillas. En esta parte utilizo el agua que todavía tengo para utilizar el color y moverlo hacia lo blanco, dándole un poco de swatch, como quien dice, poquitito más de agua, poquititito. Tengo súper poquita agua, con mucho cuidado para asegurarme de que tenga solo poquita agua. Sigo moviendo el color para que no se me haga un charquito. You don't want a puddle of water. If you have it, just with your napkin, dry it off. And then try to maneuver the color again by bringing it down to the white, little by little. Be patient, be patient. And then I'm going to use this color right here. I have a lot of color over here. Tengo mucho color aquí, así que voy a utilizar ese color en esta parte de aquí. And then I'm still gonna use some of that color to mix with this blue, just because it goes together. Como se parecen los colores, el morado tiene azul, así que por eso utilicé parte de ese morado para combinar con este azul y darle ese tono. And then I'm going to probably bring some of that color up here too. And then I'm gonna use some green. I'm gonna use colors probably. Just do a little bit of color because it goes a long way. See, I just, when I use my colors too, I just do a little bit of color like that. Just a tiny bit of color. And then I just use a tiny bit of water. Okay. Maybe I didn't use even enough water here. It didn't seem to expand very much. Okay. And then a red for my flower. Un poco de rojo para mi florecita. Y esta no le voy a poner agua porque está muy chiquita. Ahora lo que voy a hacer es que creo que ya está, la cara ya está seca. Así que con el delineador negro vamos a pasar. Ay, la cosa es que este no me funciona muy bien. A ver, ¿dónde está mi otro pin? Yo tenía otro por aquí. Y no, casi siempre lo tengo. Ah, mira, aquí está. A ver si me funciona mejor. Ok, ahora asegúrense de que no esté mojado donde vayan a poner su mano para que no se les vaya a hacer feo. Make sure that your painting is not wet where you put your hand so that it doesn't mess it up. Okay, then you start going around your work and taking the black. It's going to make such a big difference. No sé, pero me encanta delinear porque siento que hace una gran diferencia. Así. Y a pesar de que el agua, el otro plumón, se pasaba al color, igual delineando, hace la pintura mucho mejor. Puedes arreglar detallitos de ese tipo. Bien. ¿Cómo van? ¿Cómo van? ¿Cómo están? ¿Dónde estén? Espero que la vida, donde estén, sus situaciones. I hope that life, whatever it is with you in your life, wherever you are, is going well. I always send you much, much love. Be patient, hay que tener mucha paciencia en esta época de dificultad. We need to pray. Tenemos que rezar mucho. We need to pray, you know what? For all of those who are in charge. Whoever it is. Pope San Francis, el Papa Francisco, siempre dice que hay que rezar primero por el Papa para que nos mande muchas, muchas buenas vibras y siga con salud y muy bien. Y también por todos los líderes de este mundo, porque los líderes de este mundo toman decisiones muy importantes y tenemos que rezar por ellos, para que tomen las mejores decisiones para todos nosotros. Después, rezamos por todos aquellos que están arriba de nosotros, ya sea nuestro jefe, nuestros abuelos, nuestra familia, nuestros padres. Y al final, bueno, después nuestros amigos, por supuesto, y al final por nosotros, nuestros hijos, a todos los papis y mamis que están aquí escuchándome. Ustedes saben que siempre ellos van primero que nosotros. Ellos son nuestra vida, son nuestro todo. Así que definitivamente rezamos porque ellos estén bien. Y al final, pues ya, nosotros hacemos lo que podemos con lo que tenemos. Pero sin buenos líderes y gente a cargo que de veras se preocupe por nosotros, ¿qué nos queda? Con ellos nos da las medicinas o la salud o los servicios que necesitamos. Por lo menos mantener nuestra situación, nuestros esfuerzos de toda nuestra vida. Tenemos que rezar porque de veras tengan compasión y que no se enfermen de poder. We need to pray for all of those who are in charge, for all of those like Pope Francis say to pray for him. We pray for the leaders of the world, the leaders who are in charge of our lives, of our work, of our workplace, our families, our grandparents, our parents, our children, and then ourselves. It goes from big to small, because their decisions, what happens to them, affects us. Ay, me faltaron estas dos cositas, ¿verdad? De pintar. Hasta ahorita me di cuenta. Ahorita las pintamos. But it's very true that we just need to stay positive and we need to do the best with what we have. But yeah, pray a lot. Pray a lot. Prayers are very powerful. Las oraciones son muy poderosas. Y debemos siempre rezar por todos aquellos que están a cargo. Y por este mundo, por la madre naturaleza, para que nos siga dando lo que necesitamos. Tenemos que tener compasión por ella también, ¿verdad? Aquí le hacemos unas líneas. We make some lines here for the brush. The earring. I didn't do much with the earring, did I? Here. I need to take care of all these bleedings that my black did. My black color. Okay, so I know that we're over time. So I just want you to take care of this. And just because you stayed with me, solo porque se quedaron conmigo, I'm going to show you how to make real quick a dog. A crazy dog, okay? Now your homework will be to color it. Just like we did this one, okay? I want to make some details here, just like I did here. You see, I made some flower. Well, not the flower maybe, but some dots over here and some polka dots and whatnot. Some lines, crazy lines. I don't know if you noticed, but there's lines here. And just to make it fun. So I'm going to show you later what I did with this. And to make this dog, I'm just going to show you how to do it. And then you can color it whichever way you want, okay? Remember just to make sections. Hagan secciones. Les voy a enseñar cómo hacerlo. Hagan secciones para que puedan dibujarlo como dibujamos nuestra pintura, okay? Okay. So, just to be crazy, we're gonna make what parts of the doll you wanna put first. Maybe an eye. We can do an eye, right? So, let's make an eye, the dog's eye, right? Let's make the dog's eye, just like that. And then, we're going to maybe do, what about the ears? Maybe an ear, just do an ear. And the other ear, turn your page, okay? Turn your page. Maybe the other ear, two ears, one behind the other. So this is basically two ears. And then maybe the snout. El hociquito. Son las dos orejitas del perrito. Y después, okay, or the tongue. You can do the snout. Well, maybe the snout first. El hociquito primero. Así. La nariz. Así. And then maybe the tongue. The tongue. Right? And then the other eye. How about the other eye? A bigger eye. And then this break this section right here. The square. And then we make, what about a paw? A paw? A paw? Una patita? Una patita? De perrito? And then the other paw. As you can make as many paws as you want. The doggy has, what, four? Los perritos tienen cuatro patitas. Así que hacemos una patita por aquí, otra por acá. y podemos hacer a lo mejor otra por acá. Y ya les quedó otro Picasso. Y pueden poner a lo mejor un hueso por acá. Y a little bone over here.
Yeah.
And there you go. And you can put more sections over here. Maybe you have a little treat over here, another treat over here. And then you can make treats everywhere for the puppy. What else does a puppy have? Mainly those are the things, right? And then we can make this little nose black, so you know this is the snout. Aquí lo hacemos negra su naricita. Y bueno, ya les quedó otro Van Gogh. Así que quiero que... ¡Ay, la colita! Nos faltó la colita del perrito. Así le hacemos una colita. The little tail, little puppy tail. There we go. Well,
there you go. That's your puppy Picasso. Now color it and later on show it to me and how you did it. I want to see how you colored it. You can put more details, more bones if you want. Hey, have fun and enjoy. ¿Cierto? You can have a very good time. Use your imagination. Thank you for staying with me. I hope you had fun. Espero que la hayan pasado bien. Gracias por quedarse conmigo. Y los quiero mucho. Un abrazo fuerte y enséñenme lo que hicieron, ¿ok? Hasta la próxima semana. See you next week. Bye.